COVID-19 update. First oral nitric oxide therapy cleared by FDA for testing. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved a clinical trial of an experimental COVID-19 therapy. The trial will assess the therapeutic use of nitric oxide against the disease. Nitric oxide is a colorless gas that can widen blood vessels, which releases certain hormones like insulin. By relaxing blood vessels, the gas helps increase blood circulation throughout the entire body. This therapeutic investigation of nitric oxide for COVID-19 is led by Nitric Oxide Innovations, or NOI. Their drug is called Novaricid and has the status of an investigational new drug. It is in oral lozenge form consisting of 30 mg of sodium nitrite. The experimental drug is cleared for Phase 2B of 3A outpatient clinical study. But what's interesting is the participants, African-American. Not many COVID-19 trials are mainly focused on specific races, including Hispanics. According to the company's website, the trial needs 840 African-Americans who tested positive for COVID-19 in the last 72 hours. The trial also welcomes those who have underlying conditions, such as high blood pressure and diabetes. The study is randomized, double-blind, and placebo-controlled. Neither participants nor experimenters will know who received the drug or placebo. The study selected African Americans because of their COVID-19 risk. They have a 2.8 times higher infection rate, 4.7 times higher hospitalization rate, and 2.1 times higher death rate compared to Caucasians. Those with underlying health conditions have the highest risk of hospitalization and mortality. CEO of NOI, Dr. Nathan S. Bryan, said, "Everything we have learned about COVID-19 over the past 10 months reveals that diminished nitric oxide production in patients is what is thought to be responsible for the increased risk of infection and rapid disease progression." Biospace reported that previous and current studies show nitric oxide affects the replication of the coronavirus. If inhaled, patients with COVID-19 in ventilators are more likely to recover. However, inhalable nitric oxide is expensive for most patients and is not practical out of the hospital setting. So, NOI created the oral lozenge version to prevent patients from becoming critically ill, explaining the 72-hour window. The oral drug may serve as an early intervention at a lower cost than the inhalable variant. Also, the use of nitric oxide may lower the chances of complications like blood clots, heart attack, and stroke. The trial may reveal how this gas can prevent those outcomes.